Hello everyone. Welcome to another episode of Easy Law Online. This is Attorney Chato Olivas. Maraming nagtatanong sa akin tungkol sa adoption, kaya ang naisipan ko na topic for today is who may adopt? Sino ang mga pwedeng mag-adopt? Ang batas tungkol dito ay ang Domestic Administrative Adoption and Alternative Child Care Act or Republic Act Number 11642 dated January 6, 2022. There are five categories of individuals na pwedeng mag-adopt. Okay, number one, Filipino citizen at least 25 years old. Number two, legal guardian with respect to the ward. Number three, legal guardian with respect to the foster child. Number four, Philippine government officials or employees who are stationed abroad. And number five, foreign nationals who are habitual or permanent residents of the Philippines for at least 5 years. Note na sa bawat category, may mga specific additional requirements. So, pag-usapan natin ang category number one, Filipino citizen, at least 25 years old. Ang mga additional requirements para sa kanila ay ang sumusunod. Number one, meron siyang full civil capacity and legal rights. Number two, hindi siya na-convict ng crime involving moral turpitude. Ano bang ibig sabihin ng moral turpitude? Ito ay crimes that are contrary to justice, honesty, modesty, or good morals. Example, adultery, concubinage, rape, or arson. Number three, dapat ang Filipino citizen ay may good moral character and can model the same. Dapat siya ay isang mabuting halimbawa. And number four, dapat siya ay emotionally and psychologically capable of caring for children. Number five, at least 16 years older than the person to be adopted. So meron siya dapat na 16-year age gap, siya at ang child na gusto niyang i-adopt. So kung ang bata ay 15 years old, ang mag-a-adopt ay dapat at least 31 years old. Okay? Pwedeng hindi masunod ang 16-year age gap kung ang mag-a-adopt ay biological parent ng bata. So question, bakit naman kailangan niyang i-adopt ang sarili niyang anak? Biological parent na nga siya. So tandaan natin ang adoption ay nagbibigay ng legitimate status sa bata. Ito ang dahilan kung bakit i-a-adopt ng magulang ang sarili niyang anak kung ang bata ay kanyang illegitimate child. So ang karapatan ng legitimate child ay iba sa karapatan ng illegitimate child. Okay. Now, pwede rin hindi masunod ang 16-year age gap kung ang mag-a-adopt ay asawa ng magulang ng bata. For example, si AB ay may anak na si baby girl. Nag-asawa si AB at si YZ. Pwedeng i-adopt ni YZ si baby girl kahit hindi masunod ang 16-year age gap. Okay. Punta naman tayo sa category number 2. Pwedeng i-adopt ng legal guardian ang kanyang ward pero dapat tapos na ang guardianship at mayroon ng clearance of financial accountabilities ang guardian. Ito, note na ang tinutukoy dito ay isang legal guardian. Ibig sabihin, sumunod sila sa procedure ng rules of court para magkaroon ng judicial guardianship. Kaya legal guardian, hindi lang basta-basta guardian. Now, category number 3. Legal guardian with respect to the foster child. Similar ito sa category 2, kaya lang ang bata ay hindi under guardianship, kundi nasa foster care. Dako tayo sa category number 4. Ito ay Philippine government officials and employees deployed or stationed abroad provided they are able to bring the child with them abroad. Now, category number 5, foreign nationals. May mga additional requirements para sa foreign nationals. Number one, dapat sila ay permanent or habitual residents of the Philippines for at least 5 years. Number two, they possess the same qualifications stated above for Filipino nationals prior to the filing of the petition. Number three, they come from a country with diplomatic relations with the Republic of the Philippines. And number four, the laws of the adopter's country will acknowledge the certificate of adoption as valid, acknowledge the child as a legal child of the adopters, and allow entry of the child into such country as an adoptee. Now, sinabi ko na may 5-year residency requirement para sa foreign nationals, pero pwede itong i-waive o hindi masunod ang residency requirement sa mga susunod na situation. Number one, ang foreign national ay former Filipino citizen, habitually residing in the Philippines, who seeks to adopt his or her own relative within the fourth civil degree of consanguinity or affinity. So hanggang first cousin. Now, number two, the foreign national seeks to adopt the legitimate child of the Filipino spouse. Or number three, the foreign national is married to a Filipino citizen and seeks to adopt jointly with a spouse a relative of the Filipino spouse within the fourth degree of consanguinity or affinity. If the adopter is married, the general rule is yung adoption must be made jointly by the adopter and his or her spouse. Husband and wife must be the petitioners. Pero may mga exceptions ito. Number one, if one spouse seeks to adopt the legitimate child of another. Or number two, if one spouse seeks to adopt his own illegitimate child, provided that the other spouse has signified his consent. Or number three, if the spouses are legally separated from each other. So note again, ang separation na to ay legal. That means there must be a judgment. That means there must have been a petition for legal separation filed with the court and the court granted the petition. Hindi ito basta separated lang. Dapat may legal separation. So dito na lang muna tayo for now. Next, I will prepare a video about who may be adopted. If you find this channel helpful, I invite you to subscribe and to tell your friends. And remember to do justice, love kindness, and walk humbly with God. That is from Micah chapter 6, verse 8. This is Attorney Chato Olivas of Easy Law Online, making the law easier to understand. See you next time.